Hey, it's Dr. Infinity. Welcome to White Pill Media. And it's not going to be much of a white pill on me. But I'm going to see what I can do for you guys. So I decided to check out some Sword and Sorcery films just to give them a shot. I've been kind of, not desperate, well, desperate to find something that can live up to the original Conan the Barbarian with Arnold and all that. Just really trying to find something that can even get close to it. So I checked out like 5 movies. They all really suck. But I'm just going to kind of run through them a little bit. The big ones that I really disliked were Red Sonja and Conan the 2011 version. The rest are just really forgettable. So I'm just going to kind of just jump right into Red Sonja. I don't really know too much about this character. I know they're like it's like a hot chick with red hair. I know she's like a comic book character too, but don't really know anything about her. I don't think Robert E. Howard made her. I don't believe so. But this movie starts a lot like Conan does, or a lot of them kind of have this text scroll at the beginning. This one doesn't have a narration attached to it. Like at the very beginning of the film, we open up with Sonja's village being like her family is like massacred in front of her because this queen, Queen Gedrin rides in and she wants like Sonja because she's like a lesbian or whatever. Sonja doesn't want it, so she kills everyone. And then here's Red Sonja. She's left alone. And then there's this... It's a horrible way to start this movie. There's a literal Deus Ex Machina that comes in. It's literally God or some kind of deity shows up and speaks to Red Sonja. And then at, minute 2:45... The deity literally gives Red Sonja the strength to be a great swordsmaster. It is so terrible to start your like revenge flick like this, where it's like in the original Conan, he becomes a great swordsmaster. One, he's forced to push the wheel around, so he's really strong from that. Then he gets taken to fight in gladiator matches, and he becomes pretty proficient in that. And then he gets taken to the War Masters of the East to be trained. So after all that, like, Conan's this really powerful, strong, great warrior. And that makes sense, right? It makes sense that he's so strong because we've seen him work so hard and train to get to this point. And it works. It's really good. But with this, not even 3 minutes in, Red Sonja is given strength. It's terrible. It's terrible. And this is just like a really cheap film. All of these movies that I'm going to kind of briefly touch on are just super cheap. From there, the queen basically wants like this magic glowing orb thing because it has like the power to make storms and shit, but it's like really dangerous because it's like going to destroy the earth, but she wants it to like just destroy like neighboring kingdoms and whatever. Okay, makes sense. Let's see. This was weird to see, but there's a Lord Kaladin and it's played by Arnold. So we actually have Arnold in this movie, which I think is such a shame. Because if you even look at like the box art for it, it's like here's Red Sonja. She's in the foreground, but she's a lot smaller than Lord Kaladin in the background, who's Arnold, who obviously played Conan. And you know they're really just trying to ape like Conan, you know, and it's such a shame that I couldn't really live up to it. I mean, not even close. Later on, Sonja runs into these two guys. There's this boy prince whose kingdom was destroyed, and then there's this guy Falcon. And the one thing I kind of liked about this movie or took away from it is Falcon is, his actor usually kind of played like a bad guy in like movies and whatever. And I recognized him from this movie, Midnight Express. It's a good movie. It's somewhat based on a true story. Sorry for the tangent, but basically this American was smuggling drugs out of Turkey. He gets arrested and sentenced to this Turkish jail, and it's kind of like hell on earth. And one of the guards there is Falcon's actor, and he does a really good job in Midnight Express. I recommend Midnight Express. I wouldn't really look anything up about it. I would just like go in if you want like a kind of epic, like kind of prison drama movie, which is somewhat based in reality. Just like overall in this movie, like everything just looks silly. Like the armor for a lot of the guys just looks not even like definitely not threatening, but it just doesn't like fit in the world. Like you really don't believe that someone would like wear this shit, you know? 41 minutes, or one of Gedrin's like sorcerers, there's like an image of this nude woman dancing, and like I guess this is supposed to be comedic because he's like trying to conjure the image of like Red Sonja and her party like invading her lands. So I don't know, it was just a weird little comedy bit. Towards the end of it, the prince is kind of like stuck, and like Kaladin and Falcon are trying to get him out of this area, and Sonja is literally standing off to the side, not doing anything. She's literally doing nothing. And she could at least pretend to help them lift the rocks to try to get the prince out, but she actually does nothing. It's really bizarre. And it's just like overall, like blah blah blah. They show up to the evil castle, they defeat the queen, balance is restored, but just really mediocre characters. That Deus Ex Machina right off the bat is so terrible, and I don't know why you would undercut your female character like that. And I don't think anyone would really give a shit about like how realistic it is for like a woman to like be like a great sword fighter against like guys. I don't think you need that. I think people would just kind of like accept it just because like, hey, here's this hot chick in a leotard. I don't really care. You know, I get like for like realism and whatever, but there's other things you could do. You know, if you just had her like train a bunch, because they do have a scene of her like training in the movie, but you could have just done that, you know, and then maybe she has like a magic sword, because there's plenty of stories where like male characters are like, they have a magic sword or something, and then that gives them increased strength or whatever. You could easily have done that as well. But they didn't. Just really mediocre movie. I was glad to see the guy from Midnight Express, but that was it. The bad one. The really, like, awful one. Red Sonja was just, like, boring and shitty, but CONAN 2011. This is probably has to be up there of, like, some of the worst shit I've seen. This is Jason Momoa as CONAN. And I guess we'll just go right into it. So this CONAN, like the original, it opens up with a text scroll, and then you have a narration. This time we have Morgan Freeman narrating. I don't think he does a good job. I think he's really like overblown as like a narrator or whatever. I don't know. I don't really care for him. But in this one, like I said, Jason Momoa, he's CONAN, and then we have Ron Perlman as his father, and the movie just overall is just like more bloody and just more gruesome than the original, and it's just kind of terrible. It's just taking like the wrong message from the original and just trying like they're going with its own like path with it, but it's like the wrong path. Anyway, CONAN is like, his mother gets killed on the battlefield. I don't know why this pregnant woman's on the battlefield, but she is. So CONAN is literally born on the battlefield. I think they're overdoing it a bit much. And the first thing he tastes is not his mother's milk, it's his mother's blood. Again, it's just like it's laying it on a little thick. You know what I mean? To make this like badass warrior guy, they're doing it a little too much. So, Conan is 9 years old. He's like a young kid. I would say he's older than he is in the original when he's a kid. And he and some other warriors are younger warriors. They're training and they're running basically this obstacle course to try to see if they're good enough to go out with the main guys. You know, I guess in like an engagement or a battle, whatever, right? So they're running this thing. And then the kids notice that there's some strange warriors in the woods, and most of the guys just run off, and then Conan decides to face these guys. So at age 9, young Conan, I believe he's 9 years old, I'm pretty sure, he is surrounded by 4 soldiers who are armed, they have armor, and Conan is defenseless. And you're going to love this because it's so good. Conan then proceeds to butcher and kill all 4 of these men who have presumably been in a lot of real life combat situations. Conan is not hurt. Conan is not wounded. And then he walks back to the village and he drops these 4 severed heads at his father's feet. It's atrocious. You know, it's kind of surprising how quickly, like, a movie will let you know that this is shit. But here it is. It's shit. It's just awful. Hot take. My hot take for the original Conan. But something that made the original Conan so good. There are a lot of things that made it so good. But Conan being vulnerable. He's this innocent kid. His mother's killed in front of him. His father is killed. His village is destroyed. He's sold into slavery. He then has all these hardships. His love of his life is killed. He's wounded plenty of times when he kind of breaks down in front of Thulsa Doom when he gets captured. And then he literally gets killed. And then he's brought back to life. Conan is a vulnerable man in the original movie. And that's what makes him endearing. He is very strong. He is a badass. But there's more to him than that. There's a real human, like, I don't know if I want to say, like, soul or heart there. And you really want him to, like, make it. You know, you want him to defeat Thulsa Doom and you want it to be okay. Maybe that's my autistic take on it. But this Conan is not vulnerable. He's not, there's nothing really to attach to. He's more of just a really basic caricature or cardboard cutout. I think he's awful. So Ron Perlman is forging this this sword, and we no longer have the Riddle of Steel in this movie, which was so essential to the original. Instead, it's called The Mystery of Steel, and it's about fire and ice. I don't know why they removed the Riddle of Steel. I don't know why they removed Crom as being like the god of the Sumerians, because he is in the original. In this one, it's like the Sumerians are like atheistic, which I don't understand. I don't understand why they made these changes, because they're just really bad. Another thing is, so Conan killed these 4 guys, right, in the woods, and then days pass before like the rest of their army shows up at their village. No one was worried that these were scouts. No one was worried that this was like an omen of things to come. No one talks about it in the fucking village. That, why are these strange guys hanging out in our woods, you know, around our people? I don't know. The movie doesn't ask that question. It's really awful. So, we have our main bad guy of the movie. Our main bad guy is, God damn it, what's his name? Stupid. Something stupid. Dumb. He's dumb. Let me look it up. I'm sorry. Let me look it up. Oh. Kalar Zim, or Stephen Lang. He's like that bad guy in Avatar. And he's been in other stuff. You would recognize him. but he's the bad guy in the Avatar movie, okay? That's who he is. And then he has this witch daughter, and basically, long time ago, essentially, there was like this magic mask that was going to like turn someone into a god, and then the people of Hyboria rose up and defeated him, and then they separated the mask, and now he's collecting the mask back, and the Sumerians have a piece of it. Okay, so that's why he's here. Basically, so this bad guy, he has the mask, and now he needs a sacrifice to power the mask. So Conan's father is killed, and the rest of like the Sumerian village is destroyed, and Conan is able to escape, or he's left alone. And then when we next jump to Conan is like a pirate, and you really miss out on like a lot of stuff that the original had. And all of the bad guys, like henchmen, they look so ugly and stupid in this movie, especially like the witch daughter later on. They look so terrible and boring. they just look cool in the original Conan movie. They just look cool and nice. Overall, in this movie, way too many characters. That was another big complaint. There's way too many characters. And I guess in like a video game, it would work for like our main bad guy to have this many like henchmen, and you would like defeat them at like different points of the map. But way too many like I guess lieutenants would be the best word for it. But everyone looks really ugly and stupid. So now that Conan's an adult, they're attacking like these slavers, right? So Conan saves the slaves by throwing boulders down a cliff to kill like the enemy soldiers. And he most definitely, by just chucking boulders down there, killed a lot of innocent slaves as well. There's no way he fucking did it because he wasn't aiming. It's stupid. Later on, Kid Conan, he cut this lieutenant's nose off, and he has this Bane mask later on. So I thought I'd make a Bane reference because the Zoomers really love that, right? He's dumb. And then, you know, we just have, it's just not much. We have Conan, like, launching a guy, from a catapult onto, like, Zim's ship. It's a direct hit. And I know I'm just, like, bitching about the movie now, but it's like, okay, if Conan, like, just launched this guy on the catapult and the body landed near Zim's army and they found it and that was the omen, that's a good omen. That's fine. But the fact that it's like perfect accuracy, I felt was a little dumb. There's this really boring supernatural like sand spirit fight that the witch daughter like conjures up. It's really dumb and drawn out. None of the fights here are like good or like impactful. And I guess there wasn't too much of it in like the original Conan movie. And I'm going to bring up the original a lot, but it's like you have the initial village attack. You have like Conan in the gladiator pit. Then you have like him and Subutai doing some shit. And then you have Valeria. And yeah, they get up to some stuff, but it's just like a fight like boom, 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 boom all the time. It's yeah. Okay, so then at this point there's like a chick that Conan's saving because she's going to be a sacrifice or something. She's boring. And then there's a water monster like tentacle fight. This Red Sonja also had a water monster fight that was like as pointless as this one. I don't know why they went with it, but it's bad. The bad guy, like, his mask, like, has some CGI with it. And Thulsa Doom, like, appearing as a snake. That just looked cool. Later on, Zim's like, I'm going to kill you if your own father's blade. So much worse than the original. In the original, the Riddle of Steel is Conan's father says it's the sword. You can trust steel. Steel won't fail you. And then Conan later defeats... I think it's the hammer, or he's one of Thulsa Doom's, like, right-hand guys. He defeats him, and that guy was wielding Conan's father's sword. So the message is that you can't trust steel. And Thulsa Doom doesn't believe in steel. He believes in the power of flesh, the hand that holds the sword, right? And he kills Thulsa Doom, so you can't trust flesh. So what you can trust is like what's inside you. You know, the riddle of steel is what's inside you. That's what makes you powerful. There isn't a message or an understanding in this movie. There is like no moral takeaway from this film. It's just like a shitty action movie with like Conan, you know, slapped on for a title. And this was made in 2011. I'm fucking terrified to think about what they would do, you know, 11 years later. Like how awful that would be. But yeah, just really shitty. The rest of the movies I'm going to talk about are going to be like a lot quicker. Just because like I checked out like 5 Sword and Sorcery movies this weekend. And it's just like, they just pissed me off the more I saw them. Just because it seems like they're all so low quality. And I probably should have just looked at what the reviews were online and just done that. You know, if it didn't get like above a 50 or something, don't bother. Kull the Conqueror. Kull is actually another Robert E. Howard character. This guy also made Conan. I think Conan came to life because he like wrote a Kull story, which was rejected. And then he made it into Conan and that story was accepted. And that's what led to Conan the Barbarian. But this is just like a really cheap looking film. They raise like a Conan or Kull, sorry. He becomes like king of this place through some, like the king, he kills him in like self-defense and then that guy names him king. So some people are pissed off about that. They raise this dead witch to kill Kull. She then betrays these guys and essentially she just wants to like fuck Kull. And I think that's so boring for like a villain motivation. It's just they really want to have sex with the main character. It's just boring. Just kind of heavy-handed. Yeah, just a little too cliche. I don't know. Basically, it's not much happens, you know. Kull like defeats the witch at the end. And I didn't take a bunch of notes just because it was just kind of shitty and not really worth my time. Kull like saves the day at the end, and you know, and he's the happy king. Yeah, blah blah blah. He's gonna whatever. You don't care. I don't care. the Scorpion King with Dwayne the Rock Johnson. Kull, Scorpion King. All of these movies start with a fucking narration, and none of them deserve it. The only one that deserved it was Conan, the original. Bullshit. They try to trick you into thinking that this is going to live up to what the original Conan was, and it never does. So, like, he's with, like, a, like, super assassin people, Arcadius, or I don't care. I don't give a shit. But basically there's the sorcerer guy that's like taking over the world. And then he has like, he's not a sorcerer. There's a warlord and he has this female sorceress who's really hot. And she tells him like when he's going to win a battle and whatever. Okay. And then, Dwayne gets hired to kill this sorceress. Okay. Cause that'll like weaken his strength. But they get captured initially. His brother is killed by the warlord guy, and then he gets put in a hole in the desert next to a horse thief, and then somehow the horse thief gets out of his hole and then frees Dwayne. It's never explained, like, how he actually fucking did it, and I don't know why, but it just stood out to me. You know, and it's just like him, like, debating, like, killing the sorceress, trying to, like, win him over to his side, you know, and then there's the warlord guy. It's just dull. And then by the end of the movie, it's just, I don't care about the villain. I don't care about anything. He's cliche, but cliche can really work if it's just cool and interesting. And this just wasn't. The last one I'm going to briefly summarize is BeastMaster. This is like a 0 out of 10. Most of these have been like 0 out of 10s or 1s or 2s. But it's just one, really cheap, really low budget. It's just kind of, I don't know if I would call it like a skin flick or, you know what I mean? Where it's like, it's trying to make up for like the cheapness with just like, hey, here's some nudity here and there throughout the movie. But it's basically like some witches want to like sacrifice him as a baby for some magic shit. And then he gets saved by this guy. And now he like can communicate with animals. And he's trying to like defeat the bad evil wizard king. Here at like it's like an hour and 8 minutes slash like an hour and 9 minutes. It's like clearly just a fucking model of the city, not actually the city, which is okay, but I just dislike the movie so much that I'm gonna bring that up. We have like some BDSM death guards. There's this really long section of the movie where this guy in just leather is chasing some ferrets around a hallway. And I don't get it. I just don't get it. I don't know why it's in here. I don't know what... all right, and then at the very end, like, the wizard guy, he's going to, like, sacrifice some people or some shit. He's like, oh, don't do that. So they attack and they defeat him. Wait, before that, the Beastmaster isn't, like, invited to join them when, the Resistance is gonna attack, like, this wizard guy. So, they attack and are captured off camera. They couldn't afford to shoot that battle scene. So, the Resistance is captured and defeated off camera. It's just bad. And then, they kill the wizard guy. And then the movie isn't over at that point. It's not over because like some like wandering horde guys show up and then they have to fight them for like the climax. And yeah, it's like, why? We have no connection to these people in comparison to, you know, the wizard guy who has like some connection. I forgot to bring this up. There are these horrific, like, man flesh bats. They're really disgusting. That's, like, the one thing I'll bring up about this movie where, like, that has stayed with me. I guess there was some budget for those guys. But they appear twice, and they're, like, awful. They, like, wrap their wings around people, and then, like, they, like, dissolve them and just, like, spit out the bones. It's fucking disgusting. But at the very end, these, like, man flesh bats show up, and they defeat the horde for the Beastmaster and the people in the city. And you don't really know why. Because, like, it doesn't make the most sense. It's definitely like a deus ex machina why they would appear at this time to save them. But it's just really bizarre. At the end of the day, none of these movies stand up to what Conan was. And that's a shame. That's really a shame. Because, you know, like, I would honestly love it if they made, like, 15 Conan movies and they were all, like, good or decent. That's awesome, man. But that's just not how it's going to be. I don't know. You know, it's like Conan, Lord of the Rings, Excalibur. That's a great movie, Excalibur. I don't think, like, a bunch of people have seen it. So I would really check that out if you're looking for, like, actually good sword and sorcery shit. And that's, like, King Arthur and stuff. That's legitimately good. Animated movies, there's definitely more good ones, like Dark Crystal. Dark Crystal's good. But none of these movies really stand up. You know, you might find like one or two things you enjoy in them, but the rest of it is just like, blah, forget it. So, I don't know. You know, I think I've been meaning to check out like Battlestar Galactica. Like, I've kind of like spent myself on like fantasy films for a while now. I'm off them for a while. So I might kind of go back to like sci-fi. If it's anything like Star Trek, like Deep Space Nine, you know, I'll love it. So that's going to be it. There's some other shit on my channel. If you have like Conan the Barbarian, like comic book recommendations, like where to start, post that below. That would be interesting. Or like if you have like a kind of unknown fantasy movie that you think is like decent or like there's a couple of okay things in there, let me know too. Thank you. I'm out.